Hey y'all, what's up? It's your girl, Jasmine Ohin, and welcome back to my channel. You're here for another video. Whoa. And make sure that you like, comment, and subscribe. Your girl is going up, all right? Y'all wanna be a part of this journey and this sisterhood, so make sure that you hit that bell so you can be notified for any more videos. And today, we are talking about the benefits of journaling. Journaling is just a great way to process. And sometimes it's like things are happening, but you're not processing anything. So then when somebody asks you how you feel, or when you're triggered, Oh, I'm gonna give you a few things that I do that have been really helpful in me just processing, because I'm a bit of a drama queen sometimes. Can y'all tell? You can't tell? Doesn't matter. I'm a bit of a drama queen sometimes, and something that was hard for me, like processing, not even really my emotions. I think like I have the kind of personality where I can ping what I'm feeling, but it's hard to get to the root of why I felt that way for so long. And journaling's been really helpful for me primarily because it slows me down. It slows me down to actually like be in tune with my thoughts. You know, the Bible says, take your thoughts captive. And we forget that we are in control of what we think as well. Like, we can be aware of what we're thinking, and we can switch how we're thinking. And it's just a matter of changing your habits. So here's a few things that I do. Yes, I do journal, like in an actual journal. I do write in a journal. But let's be honest, it can be a little bit too much, you know, sometimes. Sometimes you don't feel like it. You don't feel like writing. If you're like me, you like, my thoughts literally go like fireworks. Like, once I'm thinking something, I'm on to the next thing. Another thought just interrupted that. I'm here, boom, boom. It's a lot of things happening. And whenever I'm journaling, that is how I journal. So I journal like I'm talking to God. Anything that I document, I journal like I'm just talking to him. And that has really helped like build this friendship, this level of intimacy that I've been craving for a while. And when I'm journaling, it's hard for my hand sometimes to keep up with how my thoughts are running. So another thing that I do voice memos on my phone. That was my mother's idea, because she's a writer. And she said sometimes she can't get to a pen or a paper, but she does have her phone. Start talking. Literally just start talking. Like, don't overthink it. Just talk. Another thing that I do, I write in my journal, I do voice memos. I also use the notes in my phone. So this is really helpful because it helps me to just get whatever I'm feeling out. Just like in my notes, just writing like what I'm feeling, what I'm going through during that day, how I'm like, if I'm super happy, like why I'm so happy, what is the joy that is like bubbling up in my stomach, like what is that? So I'll journal that as well. The last thing that I do to journal, like practically, I write, I do voice memos, I use the notes app in my phone, but I also have my notes categorized and organized in my Google Drive. So I have like a virtual journal. This is really dope because you can really just journal whatever. It's just like anything else. Don't overthink it. Like, people overthink journaling. Like, I have to say this way. I have to be this kind of person. God, make me deep. Like, you're not. You're not the deep. It's okay. Y'all, this is why I think journaling is so beneficial. Yes, it gives you time to process. It is so good for processing. It slows you down. It gets you in tune with yourself. It gets you more in tune with waiting and hearing God and listening to him. But it also gives you documentation to look back on a season in your life when you were maybe winning. Everything was coming through. Yes. Ooh, blessings on blessings. And then it also gives you moments when you were in seasons where you were in a valley and you're like, how was I processing that? You're gonna change. You're gonna change after you watch this video. Your feelings are gonna change about the next week, about how you felt last week. You're going to change. Why not document that change and just be aware of yourself? You and everybody else's business. You aware of everybody else. Be aware of yourself. Be aware of how you are doing and how you can check in with yourself. Because 2018, woo, your girl was going through a lot in 2018, okay? I remember just journaling, crying out to God, and I didn't even realize that's what I was doing. And then when I look back at the journal entries, I literally saw like a transformation of how my heart shifted, my perspective changed, and I got more in tune with myself. I got more in tune with understanding, how do I process and Why am I emotional right now? What's the thing that's making me emotional? And don't only journal when it's bad, journal about really great things. You want to document stuff. And this is kind of like nerdy, weird, whatever, say whatever it is, but one day I'm gonna be a mom. Like my mom has like books of journals, right? And she says like, one day you guys will be able to go through them and just see how I was processing life in my 20s. And I think that is so cool. So that is something that I wanna gift to my daughter and my son, my children, whatever God sees fit to bless me. I wanna gift them that. And I want them to see like mama did not have it all together. Mama was not always thinking straight. Mama, don't be thinking straight right now. Okay, I may pop you. How did mommy process in when she was in her 20s, when she was 18? And I kind of like journaled my whole life, but never consistently. It wasn't until 2018 where I was like consistently journaling. You're gonna benefit greatly. But if journaling is not for you, that's fine. Journaling is not for my husband. He's like, I'm not gonna journal. I will read 100 books. I will pray. I will do whatever, Lord. But journaling is just difficult for me. He'll write down a few things that he's thinking, but just how I will sit and journal, I will literally be in the bed. He'll walk in and I'm just like, you know, I just have to get out what I'm feeling. He's not like that, and that's okay. He found what works for him. So find what works for you. So journaling may not be for you, but find a way that can help you like document your process of growth. That's the word right there, process of growth. You're growing, girl, okay? You are not the same as you were yesterday. You're not the same as you were last year, 2 years ago. So document that. You wanna look back and be encouraged, because there's gonna be a time when you feel like you're not doing enough. There's gonna be a time when you feel like you could be doing more, that you haven't really come far. And when you have something to look back on, you will see that you really have come far and that you are doing more than what you think. So for me, journaling has benefited me greatly with myself. It's benefited me greatly in my relationship with God, and it's benefited me by taking moments to slow down. Make sure that you guys like, comment, and subscribe. If you like content like this, join this sisterhood. Join us as we grow, because your girl's not going to stay here forever, okay? God is doing big things, and you want to be a part of this as we grow together. That's right. It is a sisterhood, so we are growing together. And before I go, as I said, sisterhood, last month, I did a 21 days of prayer, and I had women from all over join in the virtual woman's worship night. And y'all, the night was so crazy. It was so lit. It was like, this has to be called something more than a virtual woman's worship night. It's a healing room. It's presented by my nonprofit, Heal Yourself. And it's a healing room, a space for us to not just be inspired. Bump that. We want to be ignited. Nobody trying to sit and be inspired, because I'm inspired. I'm not going to be inspired tomorrow. I need to be ignited. Our next healing room is May 26th. That Zoom link will be available on my Instagram platforms. Make sure you follow those. That will be down in the description box. And like I said, join this sisterhood. Father God, thank you for this sisterhood. Thank you for being a good father that can reach into technology, God, and connect us all together, different stories, different backgrounds, different journeys. You're just faithful like that. And use this tool of journaling. Use this tool, Father, to really help us be more in tune with ourselves and more in tune with you. We don't want to stay the same. We want to progress. We love you, Father. Thank you for what you're doing. In Jesus' name, amen. See you guys next week for another video. Hey, see you next week for another video. Hey, let me know some things that you want me to talk about on my channel. I would love to know. I want to know what things are inspiring you so you can inspire me. Hi. See you next week.